The old Ansel, the PB100. Still works. Had a viewer say that it's probably a switch where I'm getting all that high resistance from. It's probably coming out of a switch. But I ordered another one. I got the, I'm gonna show you guys, this is about this power probe thing. The circuit tracer. It is an awesome tracer, guys. I'm gonna show you how it works, what it's doing to work. Like, man, everybody kind of knows how to use it, but I wanna see the technology behind what's making it work. So I decided not to go with Power Probe 4 because they want like $300 for it. And I can get one of these off of Temu for like 50 bucks. I ended up ordering an Altel for $77 off of Amazon because the Altel, which I use Altel scanners, the Altel has a circuit breaker. So when I'm testing bad components, instead of every time I short this thing out, I never know if it's going to come back on or not. Okay. Luckily for me, it normally comes back on, but I'm probably damaging it. So the ones with the breaker, at least they, I won't be damaging the circuitry by doing it. It's working a lot better. So I ordered a cheap one because I'm not paying $300 for a six-year-old tool. That Power Probe 4 has been out for like 6 years, bro. And like a couple years ago, I saw a guy, I watched a YouTube video, he was doing a tutorial on the thing, and he was saying how he didn't buy it when they first came out because they wanted so much money for it. And when cut through the chase, he paid $153 a couple years ago. Well, now they want like twice that much for it. It's the same Power Probe 4 from 6 years ago. They have not changed anything on it. So I was like, oh, well, no, I'm not going to buy that. I'll just buy one of these because I use it just to check grounds. This is what I'm using it for. I'm checking grounds. I'm checking hots. I'm checking circuits. I'm touching wires to see if they're hot or if it's a ground. And then I'm applying voltage or I'm applying a ground to actuate a solenoid or a relay box isolator or bird, you know, bidirectional isolator relay, you know, module, something like that. We call it bird. But yeah, that's all I'm really doing with it. I've never really used any of these other little features of it, like the resistance and stuff like that. But you know, those are nice, but I'm using a multimeter for that stuff, to be honest with you, man. Diode testing, I'm not doing that with this. But I did find one thing that would be useful because of this. That's this little AC voltage, something like if you're doing injectors for a car. So how this thing works is, and why it works so well, is it's sending out a variable DC. So it's a 4,000 hertz frequency, and it shows up if you're looking at it on a scope as this little pulse wave. So it's basically bouncing between like 2, 5, and 8 or 9 volts, and it's making this, and it's giving you this this little alternating current. And that's what the this guy is looking for. So why do you care about that? Well, if you got even a $50 PB100, I paid like $70 because I didn't know about Temu, and I don't even know if Temu was out like 4 years ago when I bought this thing. But like I said, I never used these other features, but now that I do know about it, I can use this for when I get my signal lock with this guy. I can't tell if it's okay. So when I lock that signal in, and I get to a general location of where the bundle is, well then I can use the probe to pierce individual wires so that I can like say, okay, it's this wire. So this, you know, this is looking for an open. And when it's in a bundle of wire, sometimes the signal bleeds over. Or if it's in a bundle of wire, you're not gonna know exactly which wire it is. You're gonna know where it is, and then you're gonna take the bundle of wire and you can start piercing to see exactly which wire it is. You can tell that by putting this into AC voltage mode, which is really not like primary AC, like for your house. This is just like alternating DC. Low voltage AC, I'll say it like that, low voltage AC, and I can touch it, and when it beeps, I know I got the exact wire, and I'll start seeing a clean wave. Okay, so that's pretty sweet, and that's the only reason I wanted to like get the PowerProbe 4, and that might be a reason that you're considering getting the PowerProbe 4, is that if you have this, which is a great tool for finding opens and shorts on wires, right? This guy. The PowerProbe 4 touts a feature called PPEC mode, you know, PPECT. It's talking about this ECT. And like, it's like, you put it in the special PPECT mode, and when you touch it, it tells you it's the wire. All it's doing is looking for that 4 kilohertz signal. The same thing that you could do by simply using a regular probe, like the Ansel PB100, which is a lot cheaper than the PowerProbe stuff, or any of them, because they're all gonna have this feature. They all have the same feature set for the most part. And you can totally identify a wire. So yet another good use for this thing for me. I will not use this to insert power because I know sometimes this thing has a lot of resistance on it, and if I have to insert power, I may or may not get a good voltage drop. So like right now, it's dead on. It's not even having a voltage drop issue because the battery is really only 11.9. But sometimes I use this thing and the voltage drop is crazy across the tool, so it has some internal quirks. So now that I know that, I won't use it for that anymore, but I could still use it to find powers and grounds, or powers and grounds. And I could also use it with this guy. And the reason I want to keep it is because this one comes with a long cord. It comes with a 40-foot cord. And this cord is like really short. So like, the downfall of this thing is that what I ran into yesterday when I was working, you're working on a nice motorhome, they're gonna be more than 40 feet. They're gonna be more than 20 feet for sure. Those nice Class A's, diesel pushers, and I couldn't reach from the breaker box to the dash because this thing is too short. Now, I thought about it when I got home because I was like, oh, I get an extension cord for this thing. Now, what I could have done was, you see it uses a standard banana right here. I will have to take my leads. I have like 15-foot leads, retractable leads, I think from Lang. And I believe I should be able to plug that in here. And even though I can't get the whole box up to where I want to test, that will give me the rest of the length I need because another reason I don't want the Power Probe 4 is they want too much for the accessories. For the extension cord for the Power Probe 4, they wanted $100 for that. But the one for the Power Probe 3, the power cord, it's $20. So I don't know, man, it's kind of like they're scamming on the 4 and up, even though it's been out for a long time. I gotta clean out the truck today, guys. I mean, it's not really that bad, but I like to take inventory, make sure I still got all my stuff, especially after I've been in and out a lot, and make sure everything's where it's supposed to be and that I have everything. I don't want any surprises when I'm working on stuff. If you guys don't know, if you don't watch the channel, as you can see, I'm a big Vito Pro Pack guy. So all I run is the Vito bags. So I run a lot of Vito bags, and this is the one for here. Got my leads in the back. I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. Let's pull these out. So the set of Lang, I got these from Harbor Freight. They're alligator clips. They're gonna help do the same thing when I need that extra length. But these guys, bananas. So I can like extend the reach of my, standard multimeter lead. So that gives me 15 more feet. So when I need to stretch this out and it's not making it, I can get 15 more feet with that. And then I have to use like a, this is the one I normally use. It doesn't have the female end on it for the alligator clips, but I have like so much other, I got so many other attachments to where I have some alligator clips that will go into here. I won't have to use theirs because it's not gonna work with the setup that I'm doing. But you see what I'm getting at. After I run out of the 20 feet that they give me, I can go 15 more feet using the leads. If I have to go some more, I got a 30 foot set of alligators. So instead of using this, I can go with the regular alligators and then pull out this 30 foot set and still get the job done and still have the alligator clip. So either way, I'm in the gipper, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, I gotta clean out the truck, man. I gotta take all stuff out the truck, see what I can get rid of, see what I'm not using in a while, and see if I could part with anything, or at least just take inventory and like stuff like that old rag back there that can go, man. Old bottles and stuff. I gotta clean out the truck. That silicone, that can go. Now I gotta look through the toolboxes and see what tools I can get rid of. Just lighten the load up a little bit. Yes, I'm making room for other stuff. Yeah, anyway, guys. But yeah, my Antle circuit probe, my knockoff power probe, is working well again. It didn't like that. But, yeah, I'm not getting a heavy voltage drop right now, so I know that this is a intermittently not so good tool now. So but it's working okay now, but I know that it can like not work very well at any time. So I went ahead and bought another one. So I'll let you see it when I get here. It's an Altel. Like I said, it has a breaker. But as far as the ECT, I think this thing is great. This thing is awesome, but now that I see how it's working off of the 4 kilohertz, like I heard that, but I didn't really know what they meant by that. I want to be able to see it now that I know that I could see it. See, this is what it looks like on straight voltage. It's just, but when you put it on the AC wave, then you can like really see it. Boom. All right. She's getting cleaner. She's getting cleaner. There she is. That's my guy. Okay. So, let's see how it does on the long run. Let me hook this up. Give me a second. I want to see what it looks like through 30 foot of wire. All right, I just hooked up those two. And this is 30 feet of wire, so let's see. So if you were tracing, see, you're still getting that good clean signal. Now, as you can see, the black and the red, they're really close to each other. It's bleeding through, you know what I'm saying? So it is toning, but look, you're not getting that clean signal. So you know that's not your guy. Quickly becomes a clean signal. Now, well, what about, see, this is what I'm talking about with the bleed through. When you got a bundle of wires, you see, well, which wire is it? Is it this one? Or is it this one? They both beep because they're so close together. And that's what you're gonna run into when you got a bundle of wires, when you're using these toners. It's a common problem that I have with even these type of toners, which is why, and these have to use a two wire. Now, the benefit of these, they're wireless. So you're not limited by the length of cable going from the battery. And I had to troubleshoot that Thor Venetian using these. And I found a wire because this guy, I had 20 feet, I couldn't make it. I couldn't make it from the battery, which is at the engine compartment in the rear. And you're talking about like a 46 foot class A. I wasn't getting nowhere near from the battery to what I needed to test it. So I had to use the tried and true Flukes, and they work, but you got to have two wires. It has to bounce its signal off of. Let's see what it looks like on the probe. Let's see what it's putting out. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. It's still, I'm not getting, I can hear it. So I could still use these and touch the right wire because this only works off of contact. This is a probe. That's a new way I can use these. Let's see what it looks like on voltage. So you can see why it's better to use these. Shows up nothing on voltage, but on frequency mode, it kind of shows up as like a .1. It's like really small, but it tones out though. So I could, man, that's a game changer. Just figured that out on camera with you guys, is that this guy, let's turn this off. Say the batteries, it does have batteries in it. So when I'm using my Fluke toners, I could use my power probe after I've gotten close. All right. And then I can still use my power probe to see if I got the right wire or not. Now let's see if, let's do the bundle test. All right. Gonna use the alligator clips, do like a bundle test. Well, I need three. I need like the three-way ones, but I'm gonna have to work with what I got. So I'm gonna see if I could use this to effectively turn this thing into a single wire. Yeah, it's bleeding through. Yeah, that's no good. Cause like I said, it's the signal's bleeding through. It's bleeding through and it's sounding off on every wire. So that's no good. Got excited for a second, but that's no good because in the bundle, this is just going to bleed all over the place. It can only get you to the general location, but this guy can get you to the general location and you get a definitive, nice, clean, square wave. You know, you get a nice clean square wave on this guy, and on the wires that's bleeding, it's all, you could tell it has a lot of interference. You saw how spiky it was. So good to know, man. Always good to know how we can use these tools better to our advantage. So I'm working off of this battery, my test battery. So that's what we got, guys. Just definitely wanted to go over this and see how I could better utilize this thing with the limitations of the wire size. So learned a couple cool little things too with using that in conjunction with your circuit probe, power probe, or whatever version of it you got. All right, guys, so this is what we got. My buddy Tyrone's been trying to call, so let me call him back, see what's going on. He's in DC, make sure he's good. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. I'll probably come back and hit you with the truck all spread out. Hit you with all the truck stuff, all right?